weird. Or my mine like hangs
what
a
about,
lot longer.
What about like a half tuck? A half tuck.
It's kind of a big shirt on you.
Oh, see.
Is it because we made fun of you for your tight shirt? Well,
I wanted to apologize in the suite on Sunday.
Okay.
During that horrible game, I had a very awkward interaction with Betsy. I don't know if you remember this.
I don't.
Betsy reached out her hand, like to, I think she meant to like tap me on the shoulder to say like, I'm leaving, I gotta get out of here, bye or something.
Yeah.
And I reached out my hand at the same time and I grabbed her hand and sort of held it lovingly for about 2 or 3 seconds. And then Betsy just turned and walked away.
It sounds like something you would do.
It was very awkward. And
it wasn't awkward for me.
I felt uncomfortable about it and I have been for the last 3 days. So
what are you
like
doing
to,
with your feet down there?
I'd like to apologize. I gotta get back in the studio.
What's all this stuff for?
Next level cook-off.
Nice, got Browns cans.
Okay.
It's Wednesday.
I knew when I wore this that this is what was gonna happen. But I'm just prepping for next Sunday.
Okay, cool. Well, it's bye
it's
week.
Always Sunday.
It's bye week.
It's always Sunday at ESPN.
Okay.
I think it's funny that people in our industry, they love having secrets in their hair. Like, my head is so giant because I have so many secrets about what's going on with the teams or whatever. Not me. That guy right there can have secrets about whatever. Not me. I want to tell the fans everything I know. I don't, unless I can go in there and say it, I don't want to know it. I serve the fans.
You serve the fans. Music's been playing for a bit.
All the fans.
What's going on?
He serves the fans, and they've been listening to music for a minute on the. He serves the fans.
Do you think Rizz is listening right now?
No, I don't.
Would you trust Aaron with a secret?
Love you, Aaron, but absolutely not. It's like the last person.
Who's the most trustworthy person in the office?
It's probably Evan. It's like me.
It's Evan. It's Evan.
That's a layup right there.
That's a layup. That's a slam dunk.
Yeah,
it's Evan.
I built my brand.
All right. One's got to go. Rizz, old Ack Hammer.
One's got to go. Rizz. Don't we all know the answer?
If you had to trust one person in the office to tell a secret to, who would it be?
Would not be Aaron Hammer. I've known Aaron for 16 years, probably.
That's a very long time.
What's good about Aaron, though, is that I know secrets about Aaron that he's told me that would just blow his mind.
Right, so you've known Aaron for a couple days now, right?
Yes, I have.
How do you feel about him?
I kind of actually really like Hammer. Or what? I'm a part of Hammer Nation is what they said. So I'm officially a part of that.
What is that? Did they just come up with that?
I don't know. I found out last week I was a part of it from Rizzo, so...
Yeah.
That's kind of what I have to do now. Hammer Nation, always.
Oh my. The intern just told me he's a part of Hammer Nation.
What is Hammer Nation? That's the question.
I mean, the RBSers, like, those are Rizz people. He takes them to lunch and gives them VIP access. And
yeah.
There's a subset of the RBSers that prefer me to Rizz.
A very small subset. No,
but a subset nonetheless.
Can you name someone? Wally doesn't count. Wally just started.
Wally's getting brainwashed.
Rowan.
Who was the first one?
Wally. Wally was the first one.
Proud member, right?
And
have you ever heard of Hammer Nation?
Yeah, just on Twitter, but not an actual group of people that prefer him over Rizz.
What did I just hear you complaining about?
Dude, I am about to eat a freaking cyanide capsule and end it all right now.
I thought you were going to say a sandwich. I thought you were going to eat a sandwich.
You know I'm going to eat a sandwich. What'd you bring today?
Anyway, what's going on?
Okay, let's get started with this one. Baker Mayfield and the Browns, if he was on this team right now, which is what they're talking about in RBS, we can cut some stuff out, right?
Yep.
What a bullshit topic. What a bi-week horseshit topic. My God, what are we doing, guys? Would Baker be 3-1? I don't know. Would he be 0-4? Probably. Who knows? My God.
You all right in here? I hear slamming through the wall.
Dude.
It sounds like you're having...
You are trying to kill me.
Oh, I literally thought you were, like, dying, having, like, a heart attack. I heard, like, pound. I'm like, uh-oh, Nick's in trouble.
Well, oh, no, Nick's dying. Maybe, Chris. Keep talking. Keep talking, Baker.
I was worried
for you. Keep talking,
Baker,
and you will have to come in here and save me.
Yeah, we're not done. They're getting the stage and all that stuff.
What is that?
What's up?
What is
that? This is, I mean, you already know, this coming home with me this year. Last year, the trophy wasn't quite as big, but it still came home with me. So,
do you right have a here, shelf for it?
I'll make a shelf. I'm going to make a side dish, right?
Yep.
We have to use Lawson's chip dip. I'm going to make cheese fries with Lawson's chip dip, but I brought an air fryer.
That's awesome.
Because I didn't have one, and we don't have, like, a stove here. Yeah. So I had to put it together, though.
So what time is this thing happening today?
If I'm not mistaken, well, starts during the show. We turn our sides in at 4 o'clock, and I believe we turn our steaks in at 5. So,
do you think anybody else is prepping like you are right now?
Oh, absolutely. Last year, bro, people came in with crock pots.
Really?
With stuff. Oh, absolutely.
I wasn't here last year, so I'm like hyped to see all of it.
Nah, yeah, you were out of town. But no, people take this serious.
Look, he's got a big kettle.
Yeah. It's just a deep fryer, so,
For the fries, he's gonna make fries.
Chop up, make fresh cut fries. Not just a little, I don't need a whole bunch.
Are they better than Landmarks?
Oh, nothing's better than Landmarks.
Conversation. Talking about the relevancy of conversations today, so we're getting into it a little bit. Aaron has some takes on it. I don't, because I don't really even know what they're getting at.
Your relevancy? Listen, everybody. Listen. Aaron's secretly a Baker bro, always has been, that's...
Let me explain something, first of all. Chris, other than Rizz, and maybe to some degree Emmett, although he's a much nicer person than me, which everybody knows,
I think I have the best sense of what is and isn't relevant to talk about of anybody that's here.
Okay.
If you're not me, watch...
I hate where this is going.
No. Watch and learn. Fair?
Whoa.
Is this in response to Tony Grossi yelling at you and chastising you for doing this?
This is in response to everybody that was like, you brought up the name Baker Mayfield on the station today, which means you don't know what you're doing. No, maybe it means that I do know exactly what I'm doing. And it's not just trying to get a rise out of people or do some cheap-ass show that's going to be a free 30 minutes with a couple of calls on the phone lines. I could fart on the air. And people will want to call in and talk to me, the station that I've reached in my career. Okay? Here's the reality. It is relevant to talk about the comparison between the two quarterbacks because the other kid down in Tampa is 3-1. And you just played some guy on Sunday who had no business being on a field. That it was acknowledged by multiple people there, including me, that it was as bad as the 0-16 year. That game fit in with 0-16. Who got us at 0-16, Chris?
Baker Mayfield.
I rest my case.
You don't have to yell at me. I agree with you. And I even said on the air...
Yeah, yell at RJ.
Yeah, yell at me. I can take it.
No, it's... I try to teach these kids things, and they don't want to listen. They think they all know better than the master. Okay.
Should we get chops in here? So I want to do a trust exercise with you and Aaron.
No.
Bad boy. Bad boy.
How is Emmett's steak?
Amazing.
When I talk to
he's,
you, so
how are you feeling?
All the rumors, all the hype.
He tasted
it. It was all true.
It was pretty good.
It was all true. Emmett could have put it on the floor. I would have ate it.
Right.
Like presentation, don't matter when it's that good.
Like that. Yeah. That's like a little.
So I think the presentation of everybody else's was far better than my presentation. I think that is where I live. I don't think it's the taste. I think it's the presentation.
And the winner of the state grand, and it's the grand prize winner,
is contestant number two, Jacob the Blowtorch.
Damn.
Yo, I tried all of them.
It doesn't matter.
It's the presentation, man. I don't care about presentation.
You did just put it on the plate.
I did.
You
I don't care about presentation. I don't. I'm all about the taste.
How much are we blaming on Kiara taking a piece out?
I told her, I said, what if you took the best piece? So, this is what you don't know. I put the steak. I submitted the steak. I come in. And Kiara, who works on our marketing team, on our MCs rather, is eating a piece of steak.
What?
I'm like, where'd you get that? She's like, oh, I took it from your plate. And I was like, what if that was the best piece? You know? And she was like, oh, there's more. You know? So,